Good morning, dear students. Welcome back all of you to the physics online class. In the previous video, I explained you the point of the combination of the thin lenses kept in a contact, where the effective focal length can be given as the reciprocal of the effective focal length is equal to the sum of the reciprocals of the individual focal lengths, isn't it? Therefore, there we used the formula 1 by f is equal to 1 upon f1 plus 1 upon f2. Here we taken f as the effective focal length and f1, f2 are the individual focal lengths of the lenses they are kept in a contact, right? Then we also know that the point is the power. Power means P is given as reciprocal of the focal length. Therefore, for the combination of the lenses, we can also write the powers also. That means the same formula we can write in terms of the power of the thin lenses also. Then see here, if I take P is equal to 1 by F, then it is quite clear P1 is equal to 1 upon F1. That means power of the first lens. Then P2 is equal to, that is 1 upon F2, that is the power of the second lens. Therefore, the same formula I can modify into the power, that is P is equal to P1 plus P2. P is equal to P1 plus P2. Here P is taken to be the effective power of the combination. P1, P2 are the powers of the individual lenses kept in a contact, isn't it? And hence here also the effective power is equal to the sum of the power of the individual lenses, right? And as I discussed already, the power value for the convex is a positive and that for the concave it is negative. Accordingly, we use the sign and simplify, we get the answer here. I hope you understood the point, dear students, right? Then today, let us discuss the another important concept of the refraction, that is refraction through prism. Yes, so this is the last very important derivation for the 5 marks. Okay, after derivation of this, again I will explain all the 4 derivations which involved in this chapter for the 5 marks, right? Then the first thing need to be studied here is, what do you mean by prism? Prism means, in your lower classes, that might be in high school, you have seen prism is taken in this form. Yes, I may consider. Yes, this end of the prism, like this we can consider. Okay, so if you fold your notebook in such a thing, that forms you the prism, right? I can show you with the textbook here. So this is a what? The prism, like this you can see. And here will be one triangular face, here also one triangular face, and that consisting the 3 rectangular surfaces. You can see here, dear students. Yes, here is a one rectangular surface, here is another rectangular surface, and for the base of the prism, another rectangular face will be there. And you can see this is a triangular face, at the same back side also one more triangular face will be there. Yes, then what is the prism actually? Prism is an optical medium. It is an optical medium bounded by the 2 triangular faces and 3 rectangular faces. Prism is an optical medium that is bounded by the 2 triangular and 3 rectangular faces. Then out of that 3 rectangular faces, 1 is a rough surface. This you can take here, and if I take the cross section of the prism, then it comes one face only. Cross section will come one face only. Therefore, if I mention here the cross section of the prism, I take just the only one side of the prism is appeared, so I call it is a ABC. ABC. Okay, and this BC we call it as the base of the prism. This is called base. and the remaining two rectangular faces are polished. They are called as the refracting faces of the prism. Refracting faces. Yes, and now you can see that between these two refracting faces, there is a small angle formation. The small angle is formed between them. This is called as angle of the prism. Angle of the prism. And the angle of the prism usually we take as a only, angle of the prism. Am I clear? The base means what? The rough rectangular surface which is grounded, you can say grounded, that is a base. Then another two refracting, that means two rectangular surface which are polished, they act like a refracting surfaces, or that we call refracting faces of the prism. And the angle between two refracting faces we call as the angle of the prism. Yes, and for the grounded I can show the structure like this, right? And what is another point comes here, principal section of the prism. Principal section. What do you mean by principal section? Any cross section of the prism which is its plane is perpendicular to the axis of the prism. This we take as the axis of the prism. And if you cut the prism, the any cross section which you obtain, that we call as the principal section of the prism. Are you getting my point? Yes. I hope you understood the basic concept related to the prism. Then now we need to study how the refraction of the light is taking place through the prism. And there is one very, very important derivation for the 5 marks, that will be the derivation. The question comes, that is, derive an expression for the refractive index of material of the prism in terms of angle of prism and the angle of minimum deviation. Yes, so that question if comes, what the derivation you need to do is the N21, you have to derive that. This is a 5 marks important question. You need to derive N21 is equal to sine of A plus D divided by 2, or here you can use a delta, no problem. Yes, so or else D also, or the DM you can use, minimum angle, upon sine A by 2. This is a very important derivation we are going to derive now. Then for this, again compulsorily we need to draw a diagram of the prism which indicate the cross section, that is the principal section of the prism. Let A, B, C be the principal section of the prism, and the BC is the base of the prism. AB and AC are the refracting faces. When a light ray incident on the face AC, it undergoes a refraction here. It undergoes refraction. Then at the point of the incident, you know that there will be a normal, and the angle with respect to the normal we call angle of the incidence. When the light undergoes the refraction inside the prism, again it incident on the other face of the prism, there again it undergoes the refraction. So then it refracted out of that, or we call it is emerged out of the prism. And at this point also, if you draw the normal, this angle we call it as the angle of the emergence. Remember, dear students, it is called angle of emergence. And here at the first phase also the refraction takes place. I call it is a refraction angle R1. And this angle only means it is incident on other face. This I consider as the angle R2. Am I clear? And here I mention this is nothing but N, the point where the two normals are meet each other. I call it is a point N. And here I take PQ is the incident ray, QR is the refracted ray, RS is the emergent ray. Is that clear? And here, if the prism was not there, the light would have traveled in a straight line. So then when you take back the emergent ray and the incident, here you are finding a small angle. I call it as the angle of the deviation. Angle of the deviation. This is the angle. Angle of the deviation means what? How much the light ray is deviated from its original state. That gives the angle of deviation. Yes, if it is a minimum, then I represent that as a delta m. That is minimum angle of the deviation. And as you know, this is the angle of the prism. Am I clear, dear students? The one mark must be given for the diagram only. Yes, for this you need to give one consideration. What it is? Consider principal section ABC of the prism. Consider ABC of the prism with an angle of prism A and the minimum deviation delta m. Let PQ is a ray incident at an angle I, undergoes refraction as a QR and emerges as a ray RS with an angle of emergence E. Am I clear? Then for this we need to write one thing here. First I consider here one quadrilateral, which is that AQNR is a quadrilateral. You should know that the opposite angles of the quadrilateral is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, from the quadrilateral AQNR, I consider that. So, angle of the QNR plus angle of the AQR should be equal, isn't it? So, therefore, from the quadrilateral, from quadrilateral, lateral, that is AQNR, this angle I consider, yes, angle QAR plus angle QNR. The opposite angle in the, so quadrilateral are equal to 180 degree as I told just now. Call it is equation 1 or else you can leave like that only. Now I have to consider only the quadrilateral. Then in the figure you are also observing there is a triangle, that is QNR is a triangle here. Then you know that the total angle of the triangle is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, from triangle that is QNR, we have one angle is R1, another angle is R2 and the next angle is QNR. Angle QNR is equal to again 180 degree. When you compare these two equations, what you are feeling? Here 180 degree is there, 180 degree, and angle QNR is there, angle QNR. Then definitely the angle QAR will be is equal to what? The R1 plus R2. So if you call here only equation 1 and 2, by comparing 1 and 2 or from 1 and 2, we get that the angle QAR is equal to R1 plus R2. And already you know that the angle QAR is nothing but angle of the prism A. Therefore, angle of the prism A is equal to, or A is equal to, you can write down simply R1 plus R2. This is the most important first step of the prism. Am I clear, dear students? Yes, I hope you understood here. Right? So, this is A is equal to R1 plus R2 is the important step. Then, let us talk about the next. The light undergoes a refraction. Then, which law is played in the case of refraction? Snell's law is involved in the case of refraction of the light. But, the light when incident Actually, here is one graph. The graph shows the deviation of the light with respect to the incident light. Here I write angle of deviation, angle of deviation with respect to the angle of incident, angle of incidence. That means delta m versus the I. What the graph shows here, as the angle of incident increases, the deviation goes on decreases and it reaches a minimum value. After that, if the angle of incident increases, the deviation also increases. Then at a particular point, remember here the angle of incident is equal to angle of the emergence. Remember. Okay. So then if you consider this, so in the above expression, we can derive the simplify the derivation easily. So first, after this, we use here using Snell's law. Using Snell's law. What the Snell's law says? That says that N21 is equal to sin I upon sin R. Isn't it? So here we need to find what is the I value here. I value anna kandhidibekagada. So how to find that? Or just you can write here now. First only thing about the A is equal to, and we can substitute the angle of the deviation also. Then let us take here N21 as it is. Okay, call it is a equation number 1. Here comes one condition for a angle of minimum deviation. For angle of minimum deviation, the delta m will be is equal to, or delta will be is equal to dm at this position. At this condition, for the angle of minimum deviation, the deviation angle is equal to minimum deviation, and angle R1 is equal to R2 only, and the angle of the emergence is equal to angle of the incident. This condition will be satisfied. Then if this condition is satisfied, let us substitute that in the above equation, that is in equation 3. So then what happens? A is equal to R1 is also R2, that means R1, R2 both are taken to 1 only. So in that condition, you can write R1, R2 both are equal to R. R plus R means your answer will be 2R. Then by this you can take that R is equal to A by 2. R is equal to A by 2. Am I clear, dear students? This is a very important derivation. Up to here, I hope you understood the step. Then next, come to the point by considering the deviation formula here. Sorry, here the formula is sin of what we are going to prove, that is a plus delta m by that is 2. Then from the figure, the deviation, the total deviation delta is equal to total deviation. See, first the light undergoes deviated at this first surface and deviated at the second surface. When you take the deviation here and simplify the thing, then your formula comes I plus E minus A here. I plus E minus E. How it came actually? The total deviation delta is equal to, deviation delta is equal to delta 1 plus delta 2. This will be our formula. Then see, in the case of the delta 1 means the deviation undergoing the first surface. Here the light coming from the rarer to the denser medium. Therefore, here I write that I minus R1 I will write here. Am I clear, dear students? Yes. Plus, because already you know that in the deviation, rarer to denser means angle of incident greater than the refraction. Then coming to the second one, ray entering from where? So from the denser to the rarer medium. In this again, emergence angle is greater than. emergence angle is greater than the refraction incident angle, then therefore if you simplify this, what you will get? So segregate this positive terms, plus I and plus E is there right down here. If you take the minus outside, then under the bracket R1 plus R2 will come. From the last formula, you know that R1 plus R2 means what I can substitute here? That is nothing but A. Therefore, the deviation delta is equal to I plus E minus A. Am I clear? Then the same condition, let us use in this formula. So, for minimum deviation, delta will come delta M. R1, R2 are both are R only and angle of incident is equal to E only. Therefore, from that we get delta M is equal to I plus E, means both the side I substitute I only, I plus I minus A here. Then this is equal to 2I minus A here. This minus A, if you take this side, it comes as A plus delta M is equal to 2I here. Then finally, I is equal to A plus delta M upon 2. This is the angle of the incident here. I hope you understood this step. Yes, and see dear student, we got the R value, that R is equal to A by 2. We got the incident angle value, that is I is equal to A plus delta M by 2. When the both are substituted in the given Snell's law, that is equation 4, we get the formula this only. Yes, the last step is substitute I and R in equation 4, I as this angle, R as this angle, then N21 is equal to sine of I, means what I can use now, I is equal to A plus delta M by 2 upon, here R means I can use, that is sine of A by 2. Then have I derived the same expression? What I told in the earlier, the same expression we derived now. Is that clear, dear student? It is a very, very important for the 5 marks. That is why, see, up to now, whatever we discussed, all the 4 important 5 marks derivations over. First one is, as I told, refraction at spherical surface, N2 by V minus N1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 by R. The second one is the lens maker's formula. That is 1 by F is equal to N21 minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. The next derivation is, in the previous video we have done, that is the effective focal length of the two thin lenses kept in a contact. That is 1 by F is equal to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. The next one is the refraction of the light through the prism, where we need to derive the refractive index of material of the prism in terms of the angle of the prism and the angle of the minimum deviation, that is N21 is equal to sine of A plus, so dm by 2 upon sine A by 2. This is our important expression. I hope you understood. And within a small time, I can glance all the point. See, what are the consideration? Consider principal section of the prism ABC, and BC is the, so base, and AB, AC are the refracting surface. Over. Let PQ is a ray incident an angle I, undergoes refraction through QR and emerges as RS with an angle E. Then directly come to the step here. From the figure, we use the quadrilateral. You should know that the opposite angle, the sum of opposite angle in the quadrilateral is equal to 180 degree, because the total angle of the quadrilateral is 360 degree. Then I have taken the opposite angles, that is equal to 180. Then again here, we have the triangle also, that is the QNR. From the triangle, the total angle of the triangle is equal to 180 degree. When you observe both the equation 1 and 2, you get that the angle QAR is equal to R1 plus R2. Then angle QAR means what? It is the angle of the prism. So angle of prism A is equal to R1 plus R2. Then here, one more point we observe, that if the angle of incident increases, first the deviation goes on decreases. It reaches the minimum value. After that, again what happens? Here again, as the angle of incident increases, deviation also increases. So at the minimum deviation, we have the condition that delta is equal to, that is dm, r1, r2 are equal to r only, I is equal to e. Then when you take that condition, r is equal to a by 2, and the deviation, that is converted as a I, that equal to a plus dm by 2. When you substitute both of them in the Snell's law, finally my expression is obtained. Yes, so derive and practice more, dear students. If any things you are not getting, you can ask me. Thank you for watching.